So, apologies on the demo, because the demo is running on a virtual machine. And it went, and my computer went to sleep, which basically disconnected both of my Wi-Fi devices. So, good for you lah. Not so good for me. Okay. My name is Hazan. I'm going to begin with a very quick survey. First question is, are you using a wireless router at home?
No, wireless.
Anybody hardline everything?
Hardwire your phone.
Okay. How many devices do you have at home?
A lot.
10, more than 10?
More than 10, yes.
Yeah. How many of those devices are actually connected to the network wirelessly?
So many.
Most of them, right? So, the reason why I came up with this story is because we all know about hardline protection, right? If you don't have access to the medium, you can't attack the medium. But how about air, wireless? All right? So, just a short introduction about myself. I'm a software and hardware hobbyist. I am a security enthusiast. That's why I got this talk. Okay, I graduated recently with a computer science and cyber forensics bachelor degree, and I'm a certified hacker and a computer hacking forensics investigator.
Beware!
It's a bit contradicting, right? The number, the last one, the second last one. I'm attacking and I'm catching at the same time. Okay, so let's talk about Wi-Fi. What is Wi-Fi? Alright, Wi-Fi is actually a set of standards and protocols which defines how you communicate over the air. Okay? Wi-Fi actually means nothing. Does it, the file behind Wi doesn't mean anything. Okay, it's just a branding thing. It's not fidelity, right? It's not like Hi-Fi. Right? So the most important thing is physical, is air. How do you secure air? You can't run a tube from one point to the other and secure that tube in the air. So what can we do? Two things. You can detect. And once you detect the anomaly, you can prevent the anomaly. So, wireless threats, eavesdropping, packet sniffing, session hijacking, rogue AP, man in the middle, wireless DOS or jamming, right? These are some of the threats that are very specific to wireless because of the nature of the medium that the network is using. Okay? So what is WIPS? Right, it's a system that is used to monitor the activities that is happening across the wireless network. Okay, it can be the one that you're interested in, or might be in general what's going on in your RF neighborhood. Okay, and it will provide alerts and, if able, block the suspicious activity. So why homebrew? One, the cost of professional WIPS is very, very expensive. Just the cost of an airtight access point is $2,000. We're not only talking about the controller yet, we're not talking about the server yet, we're not even talking about the analyzer yet. All right. Easily tens, maybe $20,000 for a full setup. Okay? But I have a very small deployment requirement. I only have one wireless router. At most, maybe 10 devices at one time. So going for professional ready-made solutions is a bit overkill. Okay, it's a good way to learn networking, especially wireless networking. Alright? A lot of things, a lot of IoT devices connect over the wireless spectrum. So you need to know what's going on in that area. If you're not, people might just be stealing some things which they shouldn't be stealing, right? And because, well, why not? So just a reminder, you cannot make a system or a network 100% secure. You can just make the cost of breaking in higher for the person attempting to break in, okay? Make it hard, make it not worthwhile for the person, he'll move on and find it more easier to do. Right? Right? I mean, that's the whole thing. Okay? So, wireless AP with its, with IDS. So, component, you need two interfaces. One which can go into AP mode, which is going to be your access point. You're essentially making your own wireless router. Number two, another card which can go into monitor mode. Okay, there's actually two modes. One is promiscuous mode and one is monitor mode. Promiscuous mode means I'm already part of that network and I'm sniffing around. Monitor mode is different. Monitor mode is you're sniffing for everything. Whether you're part of that network or not, you are going to be able to sniff the packets. Okay? 8 gigs of RAM. Why 8 gigs? It's because of the IDS. Right? If you're using Snort or Serukata, you need a lot of RAM. to buffer and process all the packets that's coming in. In this case, we are running IDS, SNOT, as well as Kismet. So that's going to be double the load of packets that's going to be processed. And a 60-bit processor, because why not? I don't think there's any more 32 bits. So software components, Linux distribution of choice, HostAPD, Kismet, and SNOT. Right? So Kismet is going to be done to listen to what's going on in your neighborhood. SNOT is the IDS that sits in the AP itself. Alright, if something manages to go through and comes through, it will look at the packets, detect an anomaly, and then kick it off. Basically, just drops the packets. Okay, so this is a block diagram. Very simple. This is what's going to happen. Your DHCP server can be DNS mask, IRC DHCP. Okay, I'm lazy, I use IRC. Host APD. Alright, in front of them, SNOT. And in front of the SNOT will be your access point. Kismet will be connected to your wireless card that can do monitoring. Okay, so demo. Oh, demo. Alright. Although it's not working, let's see what we can do. Okay, so while I was at the back there, I was playing around before it died. This is a Kismet interface. So this is what's going on around in this Wi-Fi neighborhood, just within here. A lot of things. I don't know why someone's attempting to DDoS me. Okay, sure, fine. Alright, so Kismet will find out what is going on in the RF space and will alert you as to what's going on. Alright, SNOT, on the other hand, so this was just me playing around, connecting to it and sending it a lot of pings. So it will capture anomalies and then it will put it into a database and then it will create an alert report for you. Right. Unfortunately, oh wait, hang on. It's, as you can see, it's all terminal based. It's not very nice. There's actually a UI for it called Snobby, right? But what we're trying to do next for me is integrating Snot and Kismet, because right now they're separate things. There is a piece of software called Osim by AlienVault, which attempts to make Kismet talk to Snot. In other words, if Kismet detects something weird going on in the RF neighborhood, it tells Snot, hey, there's this MAC address, there's this IP is doing some funny things, it haven't attacked you yet, why don't you blacklist him at the same time? Alright, so things like Osim or Snobby will be able to do that. Alright, unfortunately I can't set it up. Setting up NAT and IP forwarding, the one that I'm doing now has a DHCP service sitting in the AP itself. Ideally, you should not have any services sitting in your IDS. Okay, your DHCP server, everything should be outside of it. Right, so in my case, what I did was just let the DHCP sit there and then pushing it up through the wireless AP card. In reality, you should not be doing that. You should be having it separately, wired in, and then you forward it through NAT and out. Right, so that's it. 15 slides, I'm done. Oh, sorry, yes. Further readings and references. So if you're interested, these are places where you can read up on such items. The first one is a white paper by Sense on how to create an IDS. The second one talks about building an IDS, and this guy created a program called Sagan, which is a parser for Kismet so that the Kismet alert can be read by Snot, and so Snot can blacklist all the alerts that came out. Okay, then obviously we need to have the Kismet and Snot documentation itself. Okay, today's talk is just to introduce you to the idea of wireless IDS and IPS. So if you're interested, maybe you can read up more about it and think about how you can secure your own wireless network at home. Alright, that's it. Thank you.